The campaign that began in 1981 was focused on saving the ancient woodland rather than just saying no to the road. Saving the woods would also save the homes in Plumstead and protect the community from traffic noise and pollution. The river crossing was part of the Ringway 2 orbital road that became a strategic trunk road and was considered vital to the regeneration of the Docklands. The scheme was supported by the London Docklands Development Corporation, the Borough of Newham, and the British Road Federation. A campaign group originally called Plumstead Against the River Crossing soon renamed themselves People Against the River Crossing due to the road scheme attracting a wider opposition. A public inquiry took place from September 1985 to December 1986. At the time, it was the longest road inquiry ever held. In 1987, the short takeoff and landing airport at the Royal Docks proved very successful, and soon the Docklands Corporation wanted to increase capacity and allow bigger, noisier jets to land, despite an assurance that development would be controlled to minimise disturbance to nearby residents. However, the suspension bridge designs would adversely affect the approach of bigger aircraft should the expansion plans be approved. The bridge could not be lowered because it needed to allow tall ships to travel upstream to Greenwich and beyond. So the government altered the bridge design to an unimpressive box girder style. Public consultation resulted in 7,500 more objections. Another public inquiry was held in July 1990, but this time combined with the airport expansion proposals. The Department of Transport said that the East London River Crossing was a done deal, and this inquiry was merely to consult on the design of the bridge. Oh, and by the way, the bridge would now need to be 6 lanes wide. 9 members of Park went to the High Court to challenge the inadequate land exchange for the woods. They lost the case and decided to appeal, as well as to ask the European Commission to challenge the government for failing to carry out a proper environmental impact assessment on the road scheme, which was a requirement of an EC directive. Meanwhile, in Hampshire, the missing link of the London to Southampton M3 motorway was going to be built right through Twyford Down. Campaigners there had lost the High Court battle. Like the Oxleas campaigners, they also lodged a complaint with the European Commission. However, the government ignored the EC's order not to start work, and construction began on Twyford Down. The campaigners sadly accepted defeat, but many anti-road protesters had occupied the Down, and regular reinforcements travelled there to hamper the construction work through non-violent direct action. Arrests and injunctions did not deter the protesters, and the media was awash with images and stories of a brutal war against the road builders. The press reported that this was the start of a summer of discontent, and a campaigner suggested that this would include large protests at Oxleas Wood. In April 1993, the European Commission confirmed that they would take the government to court over their failure to conduct proper environmental impact assessments on many projects at that time. In May 1993, the local campaigners announced that they had formed an alliance with national organisations and were appealing for people to sign a pledge to beat the bulldozers should they arrive at Oxleas Wood. Campaigners made sure that the Department of Transport were aware that 3,500 pledges had been signed so far. TV crews and press would be in easy reach to report on the planned summer protests. The government's ally, the British Road Federation, suddenly removed their support for the scheme. At the beginning of July 1993, in confidential correspondence to the Prime Minister, the Transport Minister was to announce that he would not proceed with the current plans for the river crossing because the protests against the scheme had been gathering pace, the European Court of Justice would force a 2-year delay, and the government's environmental standards had changed since the 1980s. I am so thankful for the dedication of the campaigners who fought a 12-year battle against the government. The rising mass of public opposition, combined with scenes at Twyford Down, undoubtedly helped to convince the government that the people against the river crossing would not stop to save Plumstead and Oxleas Wood.